On 16th of September and 21st of September, Bank Nifty moved 1000 points up and 1000 points down. And it was very evident in data. Ever imagine using data to take intraday trading decisions, like to anticipate where the breakout would be, where the breakdown would be, or where the reversal can be? Today, let's see one such powerful concept called open interest. By the way, if you are wondering what open interest is, how it is different from volume, and how to take quantitative decision based on it, that's exactly what we are going to look at today's video. Open interest is a simple number which tells how many outstanding contracts are there in market, be it futures or options. Let me simplify it further. Every trade has two sides, a buyer and a seller. And when a buyer and seller agrees upon a price, and that's when a single open interest is built. Wondering what's the difference between OI and volume? For this, we are going to take an example where we have six traders A, B, C, D, E, and F, and they will be trading only one stock on different days. And based on that, let's see what was the change in OI and volume. On Monday, trader A bought 2 lots and trader B sold 2 lots. That means that the total volume on this day was 2. However, if we see the open positions for trader A, there was a plus 2 open position, and for trader B, it was minus 2 open position. Thus, the total OI for this day was 2. So on Monday, we had volume of 2 contracts and OI was also 2 contracts. Let's go forward. On Tuesday, trader D bought 6 contracts. He bought 4 contracts from trader C and 2 contracts from trader E. Again, if we look at the volume, the total volume traded for this day was 6. Because trader D bought 6 contracts and the total volume sold by trader C and E is 4 plus 2, which is equal to 6. Hence, the volume for Tuesday was 6. If we see the total open positions, we can see the total number of buyers which are currently open are 2 for trader A and 6 for trader D. Please remember that 2 for trader A is from Monday and the 6 for trader D is from Tuesday. And the total sell contracts which are open right now are 2 by trader B, 4 for trader C and 2 for trader E. So if we add the buying contracts, which is 2 plus 6, or if we add all the selling contracts, which is 2 plus 4 plus 2, it gives us 8. Hence, the open interest is 8, whereas the volume is 6 for Tuesday. With this illustration, we understood volume and OI are two different but seemingly similar set of information. Volume builds on an intraday basis, but OI is not discrete like volume. OI stacks up or reduces based on the entry and exit of the traders. By now, if you have observed, on any given day, if we subtract the long position to the short position, it would be zero. That is the very reason derivative market is also called zero-sum game. To interpret OI data in futures can be a bit dicey. We need to couple it with price to understand what is happening. But in options, it tells a lot. It tells where the spot money is. It tells where the support and resistance is. It tells can we expect a breakout, breakdown or reversal. Now let's combine price and OI to understand what kind of position is being built in the market. When the price is increasing and OI is also increasing, that means long positions are getting built in the market. That is called long buildup. When the price is falling and also the OI is falling, that means the long positions are getting squared off. Profit booking is happening in market. This is called long unwinding. When the price is falling and OI is increasing, that means short position is getting built in the market and it's called short buildup. Finally, when the price is increasing and the OI is falling, this means the shorts which were built are getting covered and it's called short covering. So let's look this with an example. On 16 September, Bank Nifty gave a breakout, which was very clearly seen in option chain, and the OI change percentage was screaming bullishness from the previous day, which is 15 September. That is, the data was skewed to put side. That's the put writers were very, very aggressive, and that resulted in the breakout. And a similar kind of pattern was observed in data on 20th September when the Bank Nifty was falling down. Guys, this was just one topic around options. If you want to learn more on options trading, you can check learnapp.com, where we have courses from beginner to advanced to understand the concepts much clearly. Guys, what kind of trading related content you want to see? Please drop in comments and let us know. Also, do like, share and subscribe LearnApp's YouTube channel. See you in the next video.